गुड मॉर्निंग डियर स्टूडेंट्स एंड इन लास्ट टॉपिक आई हैव गिवन सम एग्जांपल्स ऑफ प्रेशर एग्जर्टेड बाय सॉलिड्स एंड नाउ प्रेशर इन लिक्विड्स. प्रेशर इन लिक्विड्स अनलाइक सॉलिड्स the solids do not have a definite shape. The solids do not have a definite shape. They take the shape of the containing vessels. Unlike solids, the pressure in the liquid is not the thrust per unit area. Instead, it depends on the depth, height of the liquid and the density of the liquid. It depends upon the density of the liquid and following activity will prove the point. Activity 11.6. To prove that the pressure exerted to prove that the pressure exerted by a liquid increases with the height. Depth of the liquid. Activity 11.6, to prove that pressure exerted by a liquid increases with the height, depth of the liquid. Materials required. What are the materials required? A glass tube open at both ends. Such that it is 10 cm long and 3 cm wide. A small rubber membrane cut from a balloon. Method. To one end of the glass tube, tie a small membrane and cut from a balloon. Now hold the tube in a vertical position. And pour water in it such that half the tube is filled with water. Observe the bubbles produced in the membrane. Now pour more water in the tube such that 3/4 of it is filled with water. You will observe that bubbles produced in the membrane increased. Increases. This proves that pressure exerted by a liquid is directly proportion to the height of the liquid. The pressure exerted by the liquid is directly proportion to the height of the liquid. I will draw the diagram, then easily you can understand. This is the thin rubber membrane. This is the 3 centimeter, and this is water. Diagram, and this diagram you can easily understand to prove that the pressure exerted by a liquid, the pressure exerted by a liquid increased with the height, depth of the liquid. And activity 11.7, to prove that pressure exerted by a liquid increased with the density of liquid. Materials required: a glass test tube open at both ends such that it is 10 cm long and 3 cm wide, a small rubber membrane cut from a balloon, water, saturated common salt solution. And method, what is the method? Repeat the activity as in the 11.6 by using firstly water and then saturated common salt solution. You will notice that for the given height, the bubbles produced in case of saturated common salt solution is more than water, and thus the activity clearly proves that pressure exerted by a liquid depends upon its density. And it has been found that a liquid exerts same pressure in all direction is at a given depth. Let us perform the following activity to prove the point. Activity 11.8. To prove that liquid exerts same amount in all the direction at a given depth. Materials required. What are the materials required? Materials required: U-shaped glass tube and a wooden board, plastic or rubber tube 20 cm or more, cello tape, a small funnel cut from a thruster funnel, a piece of rubber from a balloon, and a strong cotton thread, a tall cylinder filled with water. Method: mount the U-shaped glass tube on the wooden board and secure it with cello tape. You can see in the diagram, it is given on page number 132 and activity 11.8. And then hold the wooden board in the vertical position by some iron stand or otherwise as shown in figure 11.737A, and pure colored water in U-shaped such that the limbs are half filled with colored water. The improvised apparatus so formed is commonly called the manometer. And now take the funnel and cover its mouth with tightly stitched rubber from a balloon. As you can see in the diagram, activity 11.8 and diagram is given here, 11.37A and 11.37D, B, C and D. Four diagrams are there, and you can see in the diagram, I am talking about this diagram. And now take the funnel and cover its mouth with tightly stretched rubber from a balloon and secure the stretched rubber with strong cotton thread and connect the stem of the funnel to a rubber tube and connect the other end of rubber tube with limb A of the manometer. And now take the tall cylinder and fill it with water and lower the funnel in the water to the label PQ as shown in figure 11.37B. You will notice that the label of water in the limb B of the manometer rises up and in the limb A falls down. The difference in the labels of water in limb A and B gives the pressure of the liquid at point P and Q. And now turn the funnel as shown in figure 11.37C and 11.37D such that its rim is at label PQ. You will notice that the pressure of water as shown by manometer does not change. Thus, the activity conclusively prove that at given depth a liquid exerts the same pressure in all direction. When you will read the activity 11.7 and 11.8, then you can easily understand the activities. And next is the consequences of pressure in liquids. We have learned that pressure in liquids increases with depth. It has been found that when deep sea fishes are brought up to the surface of the sea, their bodies burst. It is because the blood in the bodies flows at a very high pressure. At the surface of the sea, the pressure of the water suddenly decreases, and this difference in the pressure burst open their bodies. Deep sea divers have to wear specially designed suits, otherwise the huge pressure water will crush their bodies. And the hulls of submarines are especially strengthened to bear the huge pressure of the sea water. The walls of dam are especially thickened at the base to withstand huge pressure. So this is the consequences of pressure in liquids.